were only doing, out of probably about 2,300 acres of cropland or 2,500, we were only going in and doing like 100 or 200 acres a year of cover crops. And so now we're taking it on to, you know, we've got something green growing, maybe not a, a planted cover crop, but on probably a third of the entire cropland acres right now. So we're moving that way, but we were trying to find and figure out a way, which we did by growing our own cover crop seed, to expand it out and keep some money in our pocket too.
We believe in it, but with that though, you still have business partners, you still have landlords, you still have agronomists, you still have all these other people. And so we had to figure out how to bring those people with us on the journey, because in some instances, the landlords weren't happy to see something green growing out there after. It's a complete paradigm shift of how we're gonna handle the land. And if you're not the land owner, then you have to still appease the landlord. And so it really was a blessing that we only had a few acres in the CSP program, because that gave us the opportunity to kind of fine tune a little bit the cover crops, and it gave the landlords a chance to see at least once, that then they all of a sudden say, oh, that's not so bad. And some landlords really love to hunt. And when you get big cover crops, where do they go? There's all kinds of wildlife in there. Yep. And so then they started to see, okay, this is a win-win for everybody. So it was just a lot of patience, and it was a lot of time, and just God's hand that we hit it big one time, and they walked out there, and there was all kinds of birds, and all of a sudden the light bulb went off that this works, you know? And some landlords, we never got convinced of it. They couldn't get over that paradigm shift of you need to be out there with tillage equipment, or you don't need to be out there at all. You know, they might have come to the no-till part, but they didn't come to the let's keep it active, let's keep it alive. And that piece of ground, it wasn't one that was in CSP. We put it out there because it was one that probably had been a little bit mistreated over the years. And JP and I just tried to brainstorm, what can we do to try to better it? Even if we can't have it for 25 years, what can we do to just try to make it a little bit better for next year? Because we knew we had it for the next year. And so we put it out there, and they just shook their heads every day. And the cover crops didn't get that big, but you know, the next year when we put soybeans on it, it sure made a little bit of difference. Yeah, we left the cover crops out there, didn't graze them off or anything. And so it's a paradigm shift that you have to bring your business partners with too.